Imagine myself one of those people.
I'm one of those people. Would you ever guess that?
Oh, you are not.
Bullshit, take a look.
Where? I don't see anything.
Exactly.
You've had your nose done, honestly?
Yeah, at 16, my parents' birthday present.
Thoughtful.
No, I asked for it. I had this terrible hook. The Jewish slope, we called it in Lake Forest. The only ski run for miles around.
I can't believe it, I can't tell.
Well, that's the idea, isn't it?
Yeah, but you could be lying to me.
Oh, and what would be the point of that?
To get me in here, to watch chunks of my flesh get torn away. You could be a sadist for all I know.
Hey, quit sweet talking me.
Well, they did an amazing job. Hey, wait a minute, your name's Thompson. That's not Jewish.
On my mother's side, you dope. That's what makes me Jewish. Her maiden name is Tesman.
Oh.
Look, we don't have to stay here, Adam.
No, it's all right. It just makes me a little jumpy, that's all.
It's cosmetic. It's not corrective. It's no big deal.
Well, if it's cosmetic, why can't I just put a little powder on it or something, or shade it in on the sides, like you do for Richard Gere in photos?
You mean before?
You had it done?
Yeah. Take a look at American Gigolo, and then any picture of him today. Lots of guys do it. I'm serious. Joel Grey.
Okay, that's it. Let's go.
I'm kidding. What about Sting?
Yeah, I knew he did. He looked totally different in Quadrophenia. I used to rent the movie all the time. My mod face.
Oh, well, that must have been cute. And does he look better now? Sting, I mean.
Yeah, I suppose so. Maybe it's just all that yoga, though.
Come on, I think you look great. You have a good face. And a nice shape to your nose, actually. It's just got that bit of,
What?
Well, bold on the end. I mean, not bold exactly, but
No, I got it. I got it. The sort of Rudolph effect. Well, at least I can guide your sleigh tonight.
Oh, you can guide my sleigh any night.
PDA.
Indeed.
Shall I go check the men's room?
I dare you.
Shut up.
I'm serious.
You're crazy.
Quite possibly. I still dare you.
What if they call us?
Well, they'll just have to wait, won't they?
Suppose they would.
Can you afford to be late? That's the question. Will you take that risk?
What, is this like my last meal? A conjugal visit before I'm drawn and quartered?
Oh, come on! Stop being so morbid! It's just flesh!
Yeah, I see what you mean. It's just flesh. That's not morbid at all.
It isn't! It's one of the most perfect substances on Earth. It's natural. It's beautiful. Think about it.
I'd rather not.
Oh, come on, Adam. You've bit more skin off around your fingernails than a doctor's ever going to trim off your nose.
Yeah, but that's
what?
Just...
It's the same thing. Now, that'll grow back, and this wouldn't. That's about the only difference. What's the matter with scars? Look at these. You see there?
What are those?
They're scars. Lots of little scars. You never noticed them before?
Yeah, I guess I did, but I didn't think anything.
Of course you would. Sure you did. They're on my wrist. You know what they are?
Did you try to...
No. I mean, not really. You know, I cut up myself a little. Tried to get attention when I was a teenager. But I didn't want to slip my veins open, otherwise I would have.
Oh.
I'm a very straightforward person.
Yeah, I'm getting that.
It's the only way to be. Why lie?
Right.
So, is my arm unattractive to you then because of those?
No.
Are you lying?
Not at all. I love your arm.
Love is a big word.
I know that. That's why I use it. I don't throw it around, believe me.
Well, either do I.
I love your arm.
It's beautiful.
They're like rings on a tree. They signify experience, make us unique.
Yeah, I can see that.
And that's all this is, the idea of you having some surgery. It's an experience.
I know, it just makes me a little...
What, nervous? Well, of course you should be nervous, but that's the idea. That's the adventure.
It's a far, far better thing I do than I ever thought.
Something like that. Is that from a book?
Yeah, Dickens.
Oh. Well, I don't know about better, but at least different. So you gonna check?
Oh, you mean the restroom?
Uh-huh.
Okay. What if they call my name though, seriously?
Well, what if they do?
I smell trouble, which I may not be able to do after this.
Go!
Okay. Then I can show you something.
What?
Just a little thing I had done for you.
Wait, let me see. Show me now.
Yeah, okay.
Why did you say that?
Huh?
You don't believe me?
No, it's...
It's nothing.
What? Don't do that now. Come on now. What?
That's no big...
I saw your girlfriend the other day. What was it? Last Thursday? And you were in class. So, you know, I just asked her how you were. That's all.
Yeah, so?
Yeah, and she said, yeah, but that you were recovering from an operation or something.
What?
Well, that's what I said. You didn't tell me about anything. And then she said it wasn't really an operation per se, but something you had done, a procedure.
You know, so, you know, I just thought,
it's not.
Hey, don't tell me, we're not on intimate terms.
I heard it, really.
Yeah, but whatever.
No, not whatever, Phil. I did, I hit it, and you know, I banged it up pretty bad at home, and so I had the doctor look at it, but he didn't operate or anything. The bandage just from that, the door.
Yeah, after you tripped and fell down the stairs, you told me.
Yeah, she must have gotten confused.
Oh, maybe, but that doesn't seem to happen to her very often. She seems pretty sharp.
No, she is. I'm sure it's just the way I explained it to her, I mean.
Yeah.
Right. Where did you see her?
Eleven? I don't know. Starbucks, the mall maybe. She doesn't drink coffee.
Oh, so it was downtown then. Record City. Wait, think I'm gonna steal it?
Oh god, believe me.
So anyway, it's gonna be fine.
Oh, that's good to hear.
Yep.
So everything's okay then?
No, I mean, yeah, great, absolutely.
And good. And you tell me if there's anything seriously wrong?
Of course. See, what's up?
I mean, we're friends, right? And you'd come to me.
About what? For what?
Jenny told me.
What?
She kissed you.
Oh.
Yeah, she was feeling kind of shitty, I guess. And I could tell for like a week that something was going on. And then she told me how you guys met and talked about it.
My wife and all those girls have to talk about everything, huh? And how she leaned over and kissed you.
Yeah, that's what you told me.
She did.
She did do that, but it was nothing.
Hey man, it's not nothing. She's a good kisser. Hell of a good kisser, pal.
No, I don't mean nothing, but it meant nothing. It didn't hold meaning for us. It's just...
What? You can talk for her then?
No, for me. It didn't for me.
That's all she said?
Don't tell me there's more.
No!
It's alright. Yeah. I've been acting weird like this. Whole marriage thing's just freaky, you know, so you know, it's my fault.
Right.
I mean, who gets married at 22 these days? Huh? It's not like it's the middle ages, for Christ's sakes. Just feel bad, you know, for her.
Why?
I'm kissing you, man, that's hideous. It's what those new age dumb shits would call a desperate cry for help.
Sorry.
It's alright. It's better me having to get you.
No tongue, right?
Oh, God.
Just that.
No, please.
Yeah, well, I got a free tent. You
died free. Gonna go work out.
Can't even the whole metamorphosis thing here. You're like Frankenstein.
You mean Frankenstein's monster. Frankenstein was the doctor.
Don't be such an English-lit prick, man.
Yeah, well, I am an English-lit prick.
Yeah, but you don't have to go sounding like a doctor, monster, whatever. What's it? What's up with that?
Nothing. Feels good?
Yeah. How much weight have you lost?
Not that much. 10 pounds, maybe?
I'd say more like 15.
Yeah, maybe.
And what's the whole hair thing going? And no glasses now.
It's just a few little...
Hey, man, it's the new you, all right? And plus the nails. Kenny told me about that. That's the one I just cannot believe.
It's a life change.
Oh, please don't make me throw up with the Oprah talk here.
I'm just trying to compliment you here, you know?
Thanks.
You know, I used to find blood in our phone, so it's not just this casual thing. Quit, you know.
I know that.
Well, all right then.
Oh, yeah, you look good. I can see when she kissed you.
Hell, I'm not gonna kiss you if you drink some coffee.
I'll run home and hide the liquor.
Please, man. I'll help you.
So, nothing else happened, you know, between you and Jenny?
What?
I'm just asking.
Phil,
I mean, I'm not looking for a speech here or anything, you know, just an answer. She said no, just so you don't think I'm going to trap here for you.
I don't!
We're just selling on campus and I'll rape you out the window.
And what's that supposed to be? What I'm saying is that I believe you no matter what you tell me, right? I got no witnesses here!
Nothing happened, Phil, truthfully.
So, she said.
This is not true.
You sure?
Yes.
Are you right?
Is that true? But hey, man, you gotta try.
Uh-huh.
Not that I want out of this right now, because I love scuba diving.
Of course, as we all do.
Exactly. I'm just not so sure I want to share my air tank with the same person for the rest of my life. You know? That's my problem.
Alright, take care.
Shit. I'm really sorry about that crazy shit, okay?
Yeah, it's okay.
Just don't kiss my girlfriend again, alright?
Bye.
Alright,
I'll see you.
See, listen, we should get together again sometime, all of us, I mean, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, whenever you want, just let us know, okay? So long, Romeo.
Get out.
Yeah. Yeah, wait. Where's your jacket? What? Okay, this is like too much thinking of the core job, the lumberjacky looking thing.
I don't know.
And then this Tommy Hilfiger's job, where did you come up with that now?
At the mall, I bought it.
Well, you went and bought something. You like went down to the mall on your bike and actually...
No, Evelyn drove me, so what's the...
The deal is this, okay? You've had that frumpy looking fucker for 3 years, probably more, man, and I'm never seeing you out of it ever. Winter, the dead of summer, you've got that coat on. And now you're like,
yeah, I bought the old stairs and stripes.
That's like a sailing slicker, pal.
It's their yachtsman line.
I'm gonna puke here. I swear to God, I didn't just hear you use the word yachtsman, did I?
She likes it. She likes it. Well, isn't that neat? Ain't that peachy keen and whatever the little house in the prairie shit you want to spat at?
What I want to know is, do you like it?
It's okay.
No, what I said when I asked. Do you like it?
It's fine. It's a coat.
Yeah, and let me ask you this. Did you get to keep the core job or did you make it toss it?
Who cares?
This is, I threw it out, okay? Goodwill, actually.
No, really, it's no big deal.
Dude, don't just say it's no big deal, all right? I bet you didn't throw out that farm coat our freshman year, all right?
You've lost both of us a lot of dates with that thing on.
You know, it's like perfect. It's a good little favor here. Let's not pretend that the jacket and the late John Bon Jovi here are no big deal, because when it comes to routine, you should be like Mr. Goddamn Rogers.
This is just a fucking jacket. Lay off.
I'm on floor,
fine.
So the next time we pass each other, recognize who the hell you are, pal.
Well, if not, you and Evelyn can always
head over to Rickard City and have a chat.
Hey.
I wouldn't get too deep into the moral issues during this particular conversation, okay,
Romeo?
Might have a big fucking mouth, but at least I keep it to myself, yeah?
No, it was 12. A dozen monkeys, I think, altogether.
anyway, that kind. Sci-fi, but with some meaning, too. And action.
Right, that's nice. I hate sci-fi. And you, Jenny, what kind do you like?
Any. I don't mind. But I usually like at least some romance in them. That's always nice.
Yeah, romance is good. Especially when you least expect it.
Uh-huh. You know, I was gonna say, I think what you've done with Adam is really great.
Yeah, what have I done?
Well, you know, just, he's changed.
That's right, he's changed.
That's what I mean.
He's done the work.
Of course, I didn't...
I know, I'm just saying he did it.
Right. But that's always what they say, though, isn't it?
What? Who are they?
Well, you know. Like in Cosmo, where they have those tests, asking what you'd like to change about your guy.
Now you're gonna get all scientific on me.
It's true though, right? Almost everyone I've gone out with, if you could alter just one thing, or even get them to stop wearing sunglasses up on their head the whole time, then they'd be perfect. It's that sort of deal, isn't it?
Something like that. Or it could be just that I care about him.
Phil's got like six of those one things. But it's the same idea.
Right. How is old Phil?
He's Phil. Six things away from being amazing.
Hey, Evelyn. Hi. Jimmy, hello.
Hi, Evelyn.
I didn't know you guys.
I invited her.
Oh, that's all right then.
I like your new jacket. Phil told me about it.
Oh, yes. It's new.
And your nose, God. Are you okay?
Yeah, of course it's nothing.
Well, falling down is not nothing. It looks okay, though.
You fell.
Yeah. Anyway.
Anyway, pull up some four. We got you a cocoa.
Thanks. You don't drink coffee.
It's not, it's decaf.
It's the coffee.
Good point. So I drink coffee, I just don't like the caffeine.
Me either.
Really? You don't like caffeine either, Jenny? Did you know that too, Adam, that Jenny doesn't like caffeine?
No, I didn't know that.
See, there's lots you don't know. Jenny was just saying she thinks you're great. I mean, doing great things with yourself.
Yeah, thanks, Jenny.
You're welcome.
She thinks you're just about perfect now, don't you, Jen?
I didn't say that.
What, you mean he's not perfect? Well, I mean, obviously his motor control's off a little if he fell, but...
I said you guys are.
Forget about it.
It's true, I'm exaggerating. She said, and I paraphrase, he's changed. But she implied for the better.
Well, I agree, I have, so again, thank you.
Welcome.
I think you've changed too, Adam. A lot.
Yeah, how's that?
Well, I mean, it's obvious, you know, all the minor things are pretty obvious, but in subtler ways as well. You've gotten cuter, and stronger, and more confident, and craftier.
Craftier, huh?
Apparently so. That spill you took must have done it.
I'm sorry, am I missing something?
I'm not sure, Evelyn, what's up?
Nothing, nothing.
I mean, you knew about him hurting himself, didn't you? Phil told me you had a big bandage on, so I just figured...
I know, Jenny, I saw it. I'm just kidding.
Oh, I couldn't tell.
Yeah, sometimes it's hard to read me, knowing I'm joking.
Yeah, very hard.
But I am joking, I mean. Adam took a bad fall, and he smashed his nose. But he's okay now, see? It's healed well, don't you think?
Yes.
Do you guys want salad or something? I'm hungry.
Oh, I'm fine. Jenny, are you hungry?
I'm okay. Your nose looks... How much weight have you lost?
Not that much, really.
21 pounds. I peaked, is that right?
You peaked?
His journal. A record of his progress he's keeping. 21 pounds, as of...
The last Friday, yeah.
Really? That is so cool.
I know, it's a Cosmo story in the making, huh?
That's good to know. I've been keeping out.
She knows, Adam. She's already said you've changed. I've already agreed. We're past that.
Okay, I'm not totally lost here.
You were mentioned in there too, Jenny.
Where?
Adam's journal. It's a veiled entry, but I think it's you.
Evelyn.
I peeked twice. You're right beside someone known as Cute Waitress.
Why is that? I mean, Adam.
You're not.
Something about a meeting? And a drive after in your cute little V-dub?
What are you saying, Jenny? There's not any...
You know what? It is pretty late, and I should get...
No, don't go, Evelyn. Why are you doing this?
Oh, I'm just having a coffee. Decaf.
I need to go.
I just want to talk about the kiss. Why can't we do that? You know, I think we should just put it out there. I'm a very open person.
This is inappropriate, okay?
Did you tell her about...
Oh, no, he didn't. Phillip did. Days ago, we met, and he told me all about it, Jenny. Well, everything that you told him, at least. The rest I got from Loverboy's diary here.
She's making that up. Yes.
Well, then set the record straight.
I don't want to do this right now.
Seems a touch late for that, don't you think?
Phillip told you about our talk. When? What else did he tell you?
Oh, lots of things. He's a very chatty guy when you wind him up.
I can't believe it.
Well, then you're never going to believe the rest of this.
Evelyn, let's just drop it, okay? If you're angry with me, all right.
We're just talking, okay? People need to share more. That's how this stuff happens, is covert stuff, because we hide it.
Fine. You want to go ahead. Adam wrote something in his journal, obviously, and I told Phil about...
Jenny, I didn't.
What do you want to hear? We kissed.
Oh, no. I knew that. Oh, I'm sorry. I've confused you. I meant about my kiss with Philip. That's the part I wanted to talk about with you guys. I didn't make that clear?
What?
Then that's bullshit.
No, that's getting even. Unless you guys have something else to tell me about, meaning the drive.
We didn't go on any drive.
It's not true. You didn't meet Phil.
Ask him.
Or he would have told me.
Well, apparently not.
I'm going now, okay?
Okay, we'll just let that one hang for a bit, shall we? The woods, I mean. Well, you guys are still gonna come to my show, aren't you? Phillip said you would.
Hey, look. I don't know why I'm here. I guess I just came to say I'm sorry. I am sorry if I have offended you in some way. Done something to make you so indifferent to me, cold or whatever. And I don't mean what's happened, I don't, because I think you've been this way the whole time I've known you. So sorry, but I'm not an artsy person or cool enough or you know, super smart. I'm sorry about that. But as far as just being a person, like an average type person,
doing here?
I don't know. You tell me.
I don't know. I really don't.
Are you tired of me? Is that it?
God, no, you nuts.
I just don't get this, Adam. You know, I don't want to sound old-fashioned here, but you were a step away from fucking around on me.
I would never do that.
No, you would never do that with her, mostly because she wouldn't. I know the type. She needed a shoulder. Well, what the hell? Why not a quick kiss while she's at it? Maybe a quick hand job. Who knows? She's not going to screw you, and you probably wouldn't even be able to get it up because he's your best bud. Well, let me ask you this. If it hadn't been her, if it'd been, say, that cute waitress the other night. You didn't think I caught that, did you? The chatty chat and the extra $3 on the tip?
It's nothing.
It's never anything until it's something. If she'd been there instead, out on that drive.
We didn't go at any
time. Why had she been there instead? Just ask yourself.
Jesus, next you're going to ask me if the handkerchief with the strawberries on it is missing.
I don't know that reference.
Don't worry about it, Evelyn, please.
Just want to know where we stand. You know, I thought I could trust you.
You can.
She's your friend's fiance, Adam. I am your girlfriend. Where is the trust in that?
I will do anything you want, okay? I know what I did was wrong. I do. I messed up. But I have never done that before. Lied to a person I was going out with. Shit, I haven't even gone out with someone for the 2 years before we met. So just tell me what you want me to do, and I'll do it. I just don't want to lose you.
Are you sure?
I am so sure. I love you.
I told you that's a big word.
And I'm using it. I do, completely.
Anything I say?
Anything.
Give them up. Both of them as friends. No explanation. Don't see them or speak to them again. Not ever. That's what I want. That's the proof to me about how you feel.
But Evelyn, it's...
You should always be careful when asking to be put to the test.
Jesus Christ.
What's it gonna be, Adam?
And if I don't?
Well, pretty much like these things end. I mean, in life at least. You know, if this was a movie, I'd probably see the light eventually, but no such luck. Final answer?
Choose you.
You choose well, that's all.
Listen, Adam, no hard feelings, okay? You know, I was looking for a way out, you know that, but once you start making up those plans, you know, like picking out napkins and shit, it's almost just easier just to do the thing, you know? No, you did me a favor, I'm too young to get hitched.
I don't know what to say.
Don't worry about it. Yeah, but you haven't seen her around lately, have you? Jenny?
No. No.
Yeah. Well, this ought to be good, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Jenny, hi.
Oh, Adam. Hi, Phil.
Hey, I'm sorry about you guys.
Boy, you just can't keep anything to yourself, can you?
What?
You never change, that's what.
What's she?
It's not official yet, yo. Oh, fuck, what are you gonna do, you know?
You know, we should probably get a seat.
Yeah, well, there's two over there.
Yeah, maybe we shouldn't.
Yeah.
All right. Take care, man.
Yeah.
And with that in mind, I present to you this, my newest work. It is a human sculpture on which I've been working these past 18 weeks and of whom I am very proud. I cannot legally name him tonight, as he hasn't yet signed a waiver for various items on display in the visual portion, but, well, it's a small college and a smaller town, so you got a pretty decent chance of guessing who it is. In fact, I've done all I could to be as visible as possible with him this past year. I'm more of a stay-at-home person myself, since I felt that this was an important aspect to his unique transformation. The piece itself, him, is untitled, since I think, well, I hope that it will mean something different to each of you, and frankly, anyone who sees it. His own name, however, is quite apropos. I did the MTV thing here on the base. This is a before picture I had a classmate take us near the Pizza Hut out by the highway. And that was our first official encounter after he asked me out at his place of work. A big no-no, or so I was told. And it was here that I coaxed him into eating his first vegetarian meal. Well, a vegetarian spinach and mushroom calzone can be. He also had a salad. Anyway, he said that for him, it was a huge deal. And it really does mark the beginning of my systematic makeover, or sculpting, if you will, of my two very pliable materials of choice, the human flesh and the human will. I first spotted my chosen base material. It's so funny not to be able to use names, but a lawyer actually told me I had to say that, base material, on January the 9th, the fifth day of winter semester, when I was actively pursuing another set of base material. But, well, obviously, my current creation appeared much more ripe for my work. And so I created a scenario that would allow for our eventual, yet seemingly random, connection. Are you still with me? You're very quiet. Okay. The exhibit itself will give you many first-hand examples of my efforts, some hands-on, such as videotapes and sound recordings of our conversations. Others more scientific in nature, such as growth charts, x-rays, and accompanying data. As you can see from this photo, however, the hair, the glasses, the excessive amount of weight offered a number of physical areas that made him unique and perfect for this project. A short list of alterations I've introduced would include eating better and losing weight, some 25 pounds or more, an exercise regime that would involve both cardiovascular work and weight training, the purchase of contact lenses, a complete change in hairstyles, and significant wardrobe alterations as well. He even tattooed his body for me, without asking, in a highly questionable place. Now, these are surface items, to be sure, but if I in fact tell you that I'm going to go through with it and marry the guy, you probably all shake my hand and say, wow, how the hell can I do that to my boyfriend? But this, I'm afraid, was not done out of love, or caring, or concern. This was a simple matter of, can I instill X amount of change in this creature, using only manipulation as my palette knife? I made sure that nothing was ever forced during our sessions or sittings together. I can't really say they were dates, not on my part. Although the illusion of dating was imperative, and that his own free will was at the forefront of each decision. I coaxed, made suggestions, created the illusion of interest and desire, but never said, please do this. Not once. Any questions yet? You may be asking yourselves, well, did she at least tell him? But of course not. No, I couldn't. Not until tonight. Or he really wouldn't be a piece of art. He'd be a jilted lover, a sperm fiancé, etc. But he is more than that. He's my creation. Now, it would be easy for many of you to condemn my actions as harsh or inhumane or unrealistic as you drive or walk home tonight. But remember this, like so many of you when pursuing your personal best in relationships and at work, I was interested in humanity, yes, but insistent on results above all else. How many here can say they have never looked at their significant other and or a business associate and said, they're great, they're perfect, except for just one thing? Well, I too have taken my chosen base materials and honed them into something new, something unique, and in the eyes and standards of society, something arguably improved. But with the artist's ruthless pursuit of truth and historical disregard for rule and law. I've gone a step further. I found that, with the right coaxing of my material, yes, coaxing, often of a sexual nature, I'll admit, I could hone the inside of my sculpture as well as the surface. I found myself suddenly creating strong moral ambiguity where I could detect only the slightest traces before, often in direct proportion to the amount of external change. This means that as my subject became handsomer and stronger and more confident, so his actions became more and more questionable. Against medical advice, he had worked into his face, cosmetic surgery at age 22, and insisted to those around him that he had merely fallen down. He also started to deceive his friends and myself with greater abandon during this period while showing increased interest in other women. Indeed, he had relations with his best friend's fiance and continues to harbor details from us both about the incident to this day. Moreover, he was willing to give those friends up when asked, walk away from them without any further contact or explanation after said incident, leading me to an assumption of further wrongdoing with the young woman in question. And, as stated earlier, these universal corrections culminated in an offer of marriage to me. This coming from a confirmed, albeit young, bachelor. I call this act morally questionable. For it seems to be motivated, in my mind at least, as much out of guilt as from any genuine feelings for me. He has then, as I see it, been utterly and totally refashioned as a person. As my grandfather used to say, he's a real piece of work. And yet, open any fashion magazine, turn on any television program, and the world will only tell you that he's only gotten more interesting, more desirable, more normal. In a word, better. He is a living, breathing example of our obsession with the surface of things, the shape of them. Now, my work will be fake, like chipping marble or crazy paint. It will succumb to a can of Pringles, a late morning in bed, to time itself. But for this one glorious moment, it is perfect. As perfect as I made it. Not bad, huh? And ladies, he is available. This was a startling and unexpected gesture. But obviously, I can't accept. You can examine the stone in the setting further when it's placed on display in the exhibit. As for me, I have no regrets or feelings of remorse for my actions, the manufactured emotions, none of it. I have always stood by the single and simple conceit that I am an artist. Only that. I follow in a long tradition of artists who believe that there's no such concept as government or religion, community, or even family, that there is only art. Art which must be created, whatever the cost. And with that in mind, I present to you this, my untitled sculpture and supporting materials tonight. Thank you.
Thank you.
this morning.
Hey, glad you showed up.
Well, I didn't have anything else to do. Plus, I can't show my face in the streets, so it seemed logical.
Please
don't look at me now. Or I might not make it through this. Just refer to me as it or untitled. It'll help me keep some perspective here. Just gonna shoot some piece of data all to shit, huh?
Doesn't matter, you can do what you want. You're finished.
You're finished. Wow. Most people just say, hey, sorry, can't marry you, and they say it in private.
Yeah, that might have been a bit too far.
Oh, shit, Evelyn. You are so beyond far, you are in danger of hitting Uranus, and I mean the planet.
See, you're still funny.
Just stop, all right? I was never funny, ever, or clever, or good-looking. I was nothing until you started dicking around with me. I admit it, no thing. But you know what? I was absolutely fine with that.
I know this is a lot for you to take in and everything.
Uh-huh. I got a little Gregor sounds of him going on right now, so.
I don't get that.
I do. I get it.
I know my work relied on not telling you what was going on.
Yeah,
okay?
Here in this small town, we just call it lying.
I did lie to you, yes.
Yeah, just a little. I'm a very straightforward person.
I had to say that. Sorry.
Sorry. Well, that's good. Figured I was really gonna have to work to come and help you.
I'm not sorry. I mean, not for what I've done. I just feel bad that you're so upset.
Oh, I see.
I even thought maybe you could handle this. You know, I did. Otherwise, I wouldn't have invited you here tonight.
Yeah, just me and 200 of my closest friends.
Adam, you don't have any friends. You gave up the only ones I've known you to have. Gave them up pretty easily.
Just don't hold back at all, please. Call it exactly how you see it.
I just want to keep this as truthful as possible.
Oh, that'll be different.
You're so angry.
Well, you know, Evelyn, what do you want me to say? You messed with my life and you put it under fucking glass! Might make anyone a touch cross.
What did I do wrong? Seriously, tell me.
Oh, screw you.
You have screwed me. A lot. Wanna watch it? There's a cassette up there somewhere.
You are seriously twisted up, I mean it.
Okay, what was so bad? I wanna know from your perspective.
No, I'm not gonna give you a last little thrill. Fuck that.
Listen to your mouth, Adam. You never used to talk like that.
You gonna take credit for that too, huh?
Nope. Putty guy, cute guys always have putty mouths. They think it makes them cuter.
Well, tell me how cute you think this is then. I'm up yours, you heartless cunt.
Okay then. You feel that way about me, go ahead, tell me what I did wrong. If I did something wrong.
You don't see this as wrong?
Like I said, just tell me what you think I did.
You honestly have no concept here.
Just say it.
Oh shit, look, I don't have time, okay? I'm not gonna stand here.
Exercising, or was it the new clothes that really bugged
you? No, that is not!
Everything I did made you a more desirable person, Adam. People began to notice you. Take interest in you. I watched them.
Oh, lucky me, I got to be part of your installation thingy.
You are my installation thingy. Look, if you hadn't come here tonight, okay, if you hadn't heard all of this stuff, wouldn't you still be happy? Waiting at home for me, hoping this went well, wanting to make love?
Well, that is not the point.
Yes, it is. It is the total point. All that stuff we did was real for you, therefore it was real. It wasn't for me, therefore it wasn't. It's subjective, Adam. Everything.
Not love. Not cruelty.
Of course they are.
I'll tell you something real. I should sue your ass.
You could. I did take that risk.
That's right, you did. And you're crazy if you think I'm gonna let you put all this shit on display. Our time together.
There's lots of stuff here. I haven't even put it all out yet.
Well, you might as well just keep it packed up then.
You should be proud of it, mostly.
Yeah, just save it, okay?
What about your jacket? Where should I put that?
What?
Your old jacket?
What I sprayed my number on? At the museum, it was only $4 at the Goodwill.
What did you buy that?
Just so I have it. In case.
So blackmail too, huh? Oh shit, which page of the Scorn Girl's Handbook is that, huh?
I don't know, but I bet it's in there.
I do not doubt it.
I just wanted you to know, that's all.
Fine!
What?
It's fine, forget it.
What is?
You get off and showing people my old socks and my scuzzy sheets, you go for it.
I don't get off.
It means so much to you, have a field day.
Adam, this is my work, you know? I will get back whatever you want as soon as I get my grade.
Whatever.
I will.
The ring would be nice, because my grandma's.
I'll take care of it.
Good, thanks.
Hard feelings?
Me? No, we had some fun, right?
Yeah.
But hey, that's subjective.
Exactly.
Well, then I had some fun. Fell in love and all that, and you got yourself a grade. And a column inch or two in the college paper. Congrats, seriously. But do me a favor. And don't fool yourself and think this is art, okay? It's a sick fucking joke, but it is not art.
Is that right?
Pretty much, yeah. You know when Picasso took a shit? He didn't call it a sculpture. He knew the difference. That's what made him Picasso. And if I'm wrong about that, I mean, if I totally missed the point here, and somehow puking up your own little shitty neuroses all over people's laps is actually art, then you ought to at least realize that there's a price to it all. You know? Somebody pays for your 2 minutes on CNN. Somebody always pays for people like you, and if you can't see that, if you don't get at least that much, then you're about 2 inches away from using babies to make lampshades and calling it furniture. Look, I know they call it the art scene, but that's not all that should make a scene. Anybody can be provocative or shocking. Stand up in class or at the mall, whatever. Paint yourself blue and run through a church screaming out the names of all the people you slept with. Is that art? Or did you just forget to take your Ritalin? There has to be a line. For art to exist, there has to be a line out there somewhere. A line between really saying something and just needing attention. I guess I'm done.
Wow. Okay, so you're saying I should be a better person, is that it?
That's the nutshell, yeah.
Better like you?
No, just better.
Well, we'll just have to agree to disagree, don't we?
Yes, we will. We will definitely do that. Don't forget what Oscar Wilde said.
He always had something to say, didn't he?
Yeah. All art is quite useless, he said that.
I thought you were going to go with insincerity and treachery seem somehow inseparable from the artistic temperament. That's a good one, too.
It is, yeah. Damn, I should have said that.
Don't worry about it. Look how we ended up.
Yep, alone, penniless, and in prison. Everything I wish for you. Tell me, though, one thing?
Yes.
Was any of it true?
What do you mean?
Not the things we did, or the kind words, or whatever. But one thing you ever said to me?
No, not really.
I mean about you. The nose job, or Lake Forest, your mother's maiden name.
My mom's name is Anderson.
Oh. Are you 25?
No. 22. Just. I skipped third grade.
Scars are?
Oh, they're from another project.
Got it. Got it. Gemini at least?
Nope. Pisces. Sorry.
Don't be, eh? It's hard.
Exactly. You know, I really should be heading. I've got to hook up with some guys from my department.
All right.
And the dean wants a word with me, I think. I got some splitting to do.
What's that from?
I love Lucy.
Ah, TV, that other great art form.
Yeah. So are you coming?
Not yet, I am.
Don't worry, I'm not going to do anything to your stuff. No spray paint. Just want to...
I understand. Go ahead.
Thanks.
The door locks if you just close it.
Thank you.